try again. Hiwala na nagkukwento ka mula roon.
Una sa lahat, hindi naman madaling hanapin kahit ang sariling cooking. Ang mga babae, inaabot ng lingguhan, buwanan, kung minsan nga, taunan pa na hindi yung tinitingnan. Kaya nang na-interview, isang dekalibre babae na negosyante at sinabi niya, masyagaw siyang busy. Wala siyang panahon. Ang pagtingin sa booking mo, sabi niya, ay isang buong araw na trabaho. Kailangan kang humiga sa harap ng salamin ko. Mas mainam kung una eh. Kailangan kang maayos na maayos ang pwesto mo. Kailangan perfect ang ilaw mo. Na matatapon na naman ang anino ng salamin at ng angulo ng kilalagay mo. Magkakanda buhol-buhol ang katawan mo. Nakakaano ang ulo mataas. Pinapatay mo ang ilaw mo. Pagod ka na pagkatapos noon. Sabi niya, wala siyang panahon para doon. Busy siya.
Kaya, ito ang mga interview bukod sa cooking. Naging mga usapang cooking. Mahingit, sa dalawang taong babae ang interview. Babae, matanda, bata, may asawa, walang asawa, lesbiana, professional sa kolehiyo, artista, corporate professional, sex worker, babae, Bruno, Amerikano, Pastila, Shana, Amerikano, Native American Communications Act, mga babae, Kudyo. Noong una, natutulilin sila magsalita. Medyo nahihiya sila. Pero nung masimulan, hindi na mapigilan. Ang totoo, gusto naman talaga nilang pag-usapan ng mga cookie nila. Nag-e-excite sila. Wala naman kasi nagtatanong sa kanila tungkol sa cookie noon.
ng mga nakahihintik ng mga salaysay. Ang unang monologo ay batay sa kwento ng isang babae. At kung naman madalas bukos ang saksak ito sa bawat palayam, ito'y lagi marugdod. Ang monologo nito, na pinamagatang po, ay gagawin pa na niya binibili Ray Patrick.
Mahilig sa buhok. Sa bulbol, maraming taong ayaw ng bulbol. Ang aking unang kaisa-isang asawa ay ayaw ng bulbol. Ang sabi niya, burara ito at marumi. Pinilit niya akong alitin ito. Nagpukatuloy itong namamagang huban na paslit. Doon siya nagigibugan. Sa tuwing nagtatali kami, ang pakiramdam nito ay balbas. Nakakagigiling masin pero masakit tulad ng kagat ng antik. Parang inaapoy. Naghuhumindig ang mga namumunang mga pantan. Tumagin ako na hindi ito muli. Tapos galaliwa siya. Tuloy nag-marriage therapy kami. At doon niya ipinagtapat niya. Kaya siya nangamaliwa ay dahil hindi ko na siya mapaligaya. Dahil ayaw kong ipaakit ang buki ko. May putong Bisaya ang therapy. Tinukot yun sa pagitan ng mga kausap para ipakita ang kanyang pakikisang loob sa aking asawa. At tinanong niya ako, bakit hindi ko na lang daw ibigay ang hilig ng aking asawa? Ang sabi ko, ayaw ko dahil nakaasiwa ako, lumiliit ang aking pakiramdam at hindi ko mapigilang lumiliit ang aking tingin na parang pastin ako muli. Nangamaligasgas ang aking balat at hindi nawawala ang iritasyon kahit pahiran ko ng kanadrin! Ang sabi niya, ang pamis ng pagsasama ng mag-asawa ay makasalalay sa bigayan. Tinanong ko siya, kung ipapaahit ko ba ang bulbul ko, titigil siya sa pangangaliwa? At tinanong ko siya kung marami na siyang nahawa, kakaso nakatulad mo sa amin. Ang sabi niya sa akin, dahil pinalalamdungin ang prusiso. Sabi niya, kailangan ko raw magtiwala. Nakatitiyak siyang magandang simula ito. Sa pagkakataon ito, sa aming pag-uwi, pinagbigyan ko ang aking asawa. Pinahit niya ang buhay ko para siyang naka-jackpot sa loto. At ilang beses niya akong namumuntik-muntikan ng may kaunting buto sa salit ng banyo. At hindi niya ito napapansin dahil willing-willing siya sa pag-aahit. Pagkaraan mo, nung nakabago na siya sa akin, naramdaman ko ang bulbul niya. Matalas at magaspa ang tumutusok. Kumakas ka sa nakalbog na mamaga kong buhay. Wala na itong protection. Kinalbo na niya ito.
our money only. A tattoo, see-through black underwear.
A tactical bag.
Something machine washable.
Cross tie mats, purple felt and pajamas.
Angora, a red hood.
Permanent pearls,
a leather hat.
Silk kimono, sweatpants.
A tattoo,
an electrical shock device to keep unwanted strangers away.
High heels, lace, and combos.
Purple feathers, twigs, and shells.
A pinafore.
A bikini.
A fedora.
If your vagina could talk, what would it say? Two words. Slow down.
This might be the International Vagina Anthem.
Is that you?
Feed me.
I want.
Yum, yum. Oh, yeah.
Start again.
No.
Over there.
Lick me.
There, oh,
great.
Nice.
Think again. More.
Embrace me. Let's play.
Don't stop.
More. More.
Remember
me. Come inside me.
Come inside me.
Come inside. Not yet. Ah, oh, ah, yes. No, no.
Rockets.
There. It has to be there. Every house has its
Oh, he was a catch. That's what they called him in my days. We were sitting in his new car, a white Chevy Bel Air. And I remember thinking that my legs were too long for the bus. I have long legs and they were smashed up against that board. And I was looking at my white big kneecaps. And then suddenly they kissed me. And then surprisingly, take me by control like you do it in the movies kind of way. And I was excited, so excited. And then there was a flood down there. I couldn't control it. It was like this river of life. It wasn't me, but it was him. But frankly, I didn't smell anything, but he said, and he said that it smelled of sour milk, and it was staining his car seat, and I was a stinky weird blur. He said, oh, I wanted to explain that his kiss had caught me off guard. I wasn't ordinary like this. Oh, I tried to wipe up my blood. My dress, it was a new yellow Primrose dress, and it looked so funny and snuggly. And he drove me home without saying another word. And when I got out and closed the car door, I closed the whole store, locked it, never opened for business again. Well, I paid the sum after that, but the idea of flooding made me so nervous. I never ever got close again. Ah, but I can believe. Grace indeed. I think it was dope, yes. Why? The Reynolds. I think it was much what he liked, but in my dreams, it was always Bert and I, Bert and I, Bert and I. Oh, it was always the same general dream. We were out, Bert and I, in a restaurant, something like you see in Atlantic City. All big with chandeliers and stuff, and thousands of waiters in their best. Bert would be with his orange corsage, and I'd pin it off my blazer. And we'd laugh. We were always laughing, Bert and I. Laughing, laughing. Oh, we could shrimp coffee. Huge shrimp, fabulous shrimp. And we'd laugh more. We were very happy together. But then he'd take me, he'd look at me. My eyes. Pulled me to him in the middle of the restaurant. And just as he bowed, kissed me, the whole restaurant would shake. Pigeons would flow out from under the table. I wouldn't know what the pigeons were doing there. And the blood would come and pour out of me. It would pour and pour, and there'd be fish in it. And the restaurant would be filled with much love. And Bert would stand looking horribly disappointed in me because I was again. Horrified, he would watch his friends eat Martin and they like sway past us in their computers and eating lounge. I never had those dreams before. Never did they talk out just about everything connected with down there. Moved out the uterus, the tubes, the whole works. My doctor thought he was being funny when he told me, if you don't use it, you lose it. Meaning, that's when I found out that it was cancer. Everything about it has to go. But who needs it anyway? Highly overrated. I've done other things. I love the dog shows. I sell antiques. You ask me what you should wear. What kind of question is that? What you should wear? You should wear a huge sign, clothes. I told you, it's not like that. It's not like a person who speaks. It's not being a thing that talked a long time ago. It's a place. A place you don't go. It's close up under the house, down there. Happy. Got me to talk. You got an old woman to talk about her downstairs. Well, I hope you feel better. Actually, you're the first person that I've
an eccentric tulip. The center acute and deep. The scent delicate. The petals gentle but sturdy. I did not always know this. I learned this in the vagina workshop. I learned this from the woman who runs the vagina workshop. A woman who believes in vaginas, who really sees vaginas. A woman who helps other women see their own vaginas by seeing other women's vaginas. In the first session, the woman who runs the workshop asked us to draw a picture of our own unique, beautiful, fabulous vagina. That's what she called it. She wanted to know what our own unique, beautiful, fabulous vagina looked like to us. A woman who was pregnant drew a big red mouth, screaming, with coins spilling out. Another very skinny woman drew a big surfing plate with a kind of Devonshire pattern on it. I drew a huge black dot with little squiggly lines around it. The black dot was equal to a black hole in space, and the squiggly lines were meant to be people or things or just your basic atoms that got lost there. I had always thought of my vagina as an anatomical vacuum, randomly sucking up particles from the surrounding environment. I did not think of my vagina in practical or biological terms. I did not, for example, see it as something attached to me. In the workshop, we were asked to examine our vaginas with hand mirrors. Then, after careful examination, we were to verbally report to the group what we saw. I must tell you that up until this point, everything I knew about my vagina was based on hearsay or invention. I had never really seen the thing. It never occurred to me to look at it. My vagina for me existed on some abstract plane. It felt so reductive and awkward looking at a vagina like we were at the workshop with a hand mirror on a shiny blue mask. It reminded me of how the early astronomers must have felt with their primitive telescopes. I found it quite unsettling at first, my vagina. Like the first time you see a fish cut open and you discover this other bloody complex world inside. It was so raw, so red, so fresh. And the thing that surprised me the most was its layers. Layers inside layers, opening more layers. Oh my God, my vagina amazed me. I could not speak when it came my turn in the workshop. I was speechless. I had awakened into what the woman in the workshop called vaginal wonder. I just wanted to lay there with my legs spread, examining my vagina forever. It was better than the Grand Canyon, ancient and full of grace. It had the innocence and freshness of a proper English garden. It was funny. Very funny. It made me laugh. It could hide and seek, open and close. And then the woman in the workshop asked, how many women in the workshop have had orgasms? Two women tentatively raised their hands. I did not raise my hand, but I had had orgasms. I did not raise my hand because they were accidental orgasms. They happened to me. They would happen in my dreams, and I would wake in splendor. They happened a lot in the water, mostly in the bath, and at once in Cape Cod. They happened on horses, on bicycles, sometimes on the treadmill at the gym. I did not trace my hand, because although I'd had orgasms, I did not know how to make one happen. I thought it was a mystical, magical thing. I did not want to interfere. It felt wrong at me, both. It felt contrived, manipulative. It felt Hollywood. The surprise would be gone. And the mystery. The problem, of course, was that the surprise had been gone for 2 weeks. I have not had a magical, accidental orgasm for a long time. And I was frantic. That's why I was in the vagina workshop. And then the moment had arrived that I had dreaded and longed for. The woman in the workshop asked us to take out our hand mirrors again and to see if we could locate our clitoris. We were there, the group of us women, on a box, on a mat, searching for a spot, a locus, a reason.
Re-entering the surface of the earth. It was very quiet, this re-entry, quiet and gentle. We bounced and landed and bounced. I felt myself coming into my own muscles, my blood, my cells, and then I slid into my vagina. It was suddenly easy, and I felt all warm and young and alive and pulsing and ready. And then, with my eyes still closed, without looking, I put my finger on what has suddenly become me. There was a little quivering at first, which urged me to stay. And then the quivering became another quick, and then also the layers dividing and subdividing, breaking open into an ancient horizon of light and silence, which broke open into a plane of music and colors and innocence and longing. And I felt connection, calling connection, as I lay there thrashing about on my shiny.
get taken to the hospital where they sew me up from where it's been torn apart. Memory. 10 years old. I'm at my father's house, and they're having a party upstairs, and everybody's drinking. And I'm playing alone in the basement, trying on my new cut-like bra and panties that my father's girlfriend gave to me. And then suddenly, my father's best friend, this big man named Alfred, comes up from behind me and pulls down my underpants and sticks his big hard penis inside my coochie smarter. I scream, I kick, I try to fight him off, but he's got it in me already. And then my father's there with his gun. And then there's a big, loud, horrible noise. And then there's blood all over Alfred and me. Lots of blood. Oh, I am sure my coochie scorcher is finally falling off this time. Alfred is paralyzed for life. And my mama, she doesn't let me see my father for 7 years. Memory. 16 years old. There's this gorgeous 24-year-old lady who lives in our neighborhood, and I look at her all the time. And then one day, she invites me inside her car, and she tells me, "Do you like kissing boys?" And I tell her I do not like that. And she says she wants to show me something. And then she leans over, and she kisses me on the lips with her lips. And then she puts her tongue inside my mouth and, wow! Wow! And then she asks me if I want to go to her house. And then she kisses me again. But this time she tells me to relax and to feel it, to let our tongues feel it. So she asks my mama if I can spend the night. And my mama, she's so impressed by this beautiful, successful lady has taken an interest in me. Well, I'm so scared, I can't wait. And her apartment's fantastic. She's got it hooked up. It's the 70s, the beads, the fluffy pillows, the mood lights. Oh, I decide right there and then, I want to be a secretary like her when I grow up. So this poor lady makes a vodka for herself, and she asks me what I want to drink, and I say, "Same as you're drinking?" And she says she didn't think that my mama would approve of me drinking vodka. And I tell her, I don't think she would approve of me kissing girls either. So the pretty lady makes me a drink. And then she changes into a chocolate satin teddy, and it's so beautiful. Oh, she's so beautiful. I always thought bull daggers were ugly. So I tells her, "Wow, you look great." And she says, "Well, so do you." But I say, "But I only got this cotton white bright underpants." So she changes me into another satin teddy, and it's lavender like the first soft days of spring. And oh, by this time, the water has gone to my head, and I'm loose, and I'm ready. And there's a picture hanging over her bed of a naked black woman with a huge afro. And this pretty lady, she lays me down gently on the bed, and just our bodies rubbing against each other makes me come. And then she does everything to my coochie snorcher and me that I thought was nasty before. And it makes me so proud, it makes me so wild. And she says, "Your vagina, untouched by man, smells so nice, so clean. I wish I could keep it that way forever." And it drives me crazy, it makes me wild. And then the phone rings. And of course, it's my mama. And I'm sure she knows because she always catches me at everything. And by this time, I'm breathing heavily, so I try to act normal. And I get to the phone, and she says, "What's the matter with you, child? Have you been running?" And I say, "Oh, mama, exercise." And she tells the pretty lady
I need to know about my coochie's larger. Oh, all the different ways to give myself pleasure. She's very thorough. She says it's important I know how to give myself pleasure, so I won't ever, ever need to depend on any man for that. The next morning, I'm worried I've turned into a butch. I'm so in love with her, but she just laughs, and I never see her again. I realized later that she was my surprising, unexpected, politically incorrect salvation. Why, she transformed my sorry-ass coochie snorcher and raised it into some kind of heaven.
Ordinaryong lalaki na kilala ko. interesado sa sexy lingerie.
Wait, tagalaw dati siyang nasa lili.
Hindi kayo binabahagi ang kanyang mga nasa sa loob.
Wala siyang mga problema o mga issue o hindi siya alcoholic. Hindi siya masyadong nakakaduwa o matatas magsalita. O yung tipo pang lalaki na may pagka-misteryoso. Hindi siya masamang tao, hindi siya malita, hindi siya yung tipong lalaki na sarili lang iniisip lagi. O yung charismatic. Hindi siya mabilis magmaneho. Hindi ko naman talaga nagustuhan si Bob. Hindi ko man lang siya mapapansin. Hindi niya mabilis na naipulot ang mga baryang nalaglag sa isang restaurant. Nung ipinulit niya sa akin ang mga barya, di inaasahang nadantayan ang kanyang kamayan sa akin. At may kung anong nangyari. Nakipagtalik ako sa kanya. At doon nagsimula ang kumala. Mangyari pala ay mahal na mahal ni Bob ang mga hobby. Ito siyang eksperto. The connoisseur. Gusto niya ang pakiramdamin sa kanyang palad, sa bawat aklos, ang amoy nito sa kanyang ulong, ang lasa nito sa kanyang mula. At higit sa lahat, gusto ni Bob ang itsura ng mga puti. Kailangan niya itong titigan. Nung nagtalik kami sa unang pagkakataon, sabi ni Bob, kailangan daw niya akong makita. Nandito lang ako, sabi ko.
Thank you.
mula sa Bosnia ang na-interview sa kasagsagan ng digmaan ng Yugoslavia sa mga refugee camps at centers. Dalawa, hanggang 100,000 kababaihan ang nagahasa sa kalagitnaan ng Europa bilang sistematikong pamamaraan ng digmaan. Nakalulungkot. Nakalulungkot ang kakulangan ng pakikialam ng lahat upang pigilan ito. Ngunit ang katotohanan, dito sa bansang tinutukoy, mahigit 700,000 kababaihan ang nagahasa kahit walang gerang nangyayari sa kasalukuyan. Ang susunod na monologo ay batay sa kwento ng isang babae sa Bosnia. Iniahatid namin ang pagtatanghal niya kahapon sa babae nito at sa kamangha-manghang kababaihan ng Bosnia. Pati na rin sa lahat ng mga babae magpahanggang ngayon ay alipin pa rin ang kultura ng katahimikan.
Mula nung marunit kong mapunit ang balat at pumalahaw. Mula ng naputol ang isang kabiraso ng aking kwenta sa aking palat. Ang isang bahag ng labi. At ngayon, kuya lang nawala ang labi niyo. Ang aking kwarta ay tubig na buhay. Buhay ng nayon. Ang aking nayon ay ang aking bayan sinilang. Ang aking bayan. Hindi na mula na. Maghalinginat sila sa loob ng pitong araw. Ang araw ng tae at sunog na karnein, iniiwan nila sa akin ng kanilang maruming tapon, aking katok-tok. Ako'y naging isang dagat na nanang atlas. Lahat ng pananim ay namatay. Lahat ng isda sa tubig. Ang aking kwarta ay tubig ng buhay. Na yung buhay, sinalakay nila ito, kinatay, sinunog, tinubak!
It's pissed off!
mean, what's the deal? An army of people out there thinking up ways to torture my poor ass, gentle, loving vagina. Spending the day constructing psycho products and nasty ideas to undermine my pussy. Vagina motherfuckers! All this shit they're constantly trying to shove up us. Stuff us up. Beat us up. Make it go away. Well, my vagina's not going away. It's pissed off and staying right here. Like tampons. What the hell is that? A lot of my fucking cotton stuffed up there. Why can't they find a way to suddenly lubricate the tampon? As soon as my vagina sees it, it goes into shock. It says, forget it. It closes up. We need to work with the vagina. Introduce it to things. Prepare the way. That's what foreplay's all about. You gotta convince my vagina. Seduce my vagina. Engage my vagina's. You can't do that with a dry wad of fucking cotton! Stop shoving things up me! Stop shoving and stop cleaning it up! My vagina doesn't need to be cleaned up! It smells good already! Don't try to decorate! And don't believe them when he tells you it smells like rose petals! When it's supposed to smell like pussy! That's what they're doing! Trying to clean it up! Make it smell like bathroom spray! Or a garden! All those dew sprays! Floral! Berry! Rain! I don't want my pussy to smell like rain! All cleaned up like washing a dish after you cooked it! I want to taste the fish. That's why I ordered it. Then there's those exams. Who thought them up? There's gotta be a better way to do those exams. Why the scary paper dress that scratches your tits and crunches when you lie down? So you feel like a wad of paper someone threw away. Why the rubber gloves? Why the flashlight all up there? Why the Nazi steel stirrups? What's that? My vagina's angry about those visits. It gets defended weeks in advance. It won't go out of the house. But then... then you get there. Don't you hate that? Scoot down. Relax your vagina. Why? So you can shove things inside it? I don't think so. Why can't they find some nice, delicious purple velvet and wrap it around me? Lay me down on some feathery cotton spread. Put on some friendly pink or blue gloves and rest my feet on some fur-covered stirrups. Work with my vagina. But no! More tortures! Dry motherfucking cotton and thong underwear. That's the worst. Thong underwear, who thought that up? Up all the time, get stuck in the back of your rusty butt. Vagina's supposed to be loose and wide, not held together.
That's why girls are so bad. We need to move and spread. Talk and talk. Vaginas need comfort. Say something like that. Something to give them pleasure. No, of course they won't do that. Hate to see a woman having pleasure, particularly sexual pleasure. I mean, make a nice pair of soft cotton underwear with a French tickler built in. Women would be coming all day, coming in the supermarket, coming on the subway, coming happy vagina. They wouldn't be able to stand it, seeing all those energized, not taking shit, hot, happy vaginas. You know, if my vagina could talk, it would talk about itself, like me. It would talk about other vaginas. It would do vagina impressions. Oh, it would wear Harry Winston diamonds. No clothing. Just there. All draped in diamonds. My vagina helped release a giant thing. It thought it would be doing more of that. It's not. Now it wants to travel. Doesn't want a lot of company. It wants to be. Smoke things. And get out more. Wants sex. Loves sex. It wants to go deeper. It's hungry for depth. It wants kindness, it wants change, it wants silence and freedom, gentle kisses, warm liquids, and deep touch. It wants chocolate, it wants to scream! It wants to stop being angry. It wants to come. My vagina. Well, it wants everything.
Oh, that's nice. In junior high, round trips before
rock beds. I went down and lay there. My mother was so uncomfortable. One night, I came late and snuck into bed without turning on any light. My mother had found the used rags and put them between the sheets of my bed.
I was 12 years old, stood in my underpants. I had bought a dress, looked down on the staircase. There it was.
Looked down, and I saw blood. 7th grade. My mother started not in my underwear.
Then she gave me plastic diapers.
My mom was very warm.
Let's get you a pad. My friend, Marsha, they separated when she got hers. They had dinner for her.
We all wanted our period. We all wanted it. Now.
13 years old. It was before Kotex. Had to wash her dress. I was fat and poor. Loved the fact my dress in church. Didn't show, but I was guilty. I was 10 and a half. No preparation. Wrong look on my underpants.
She showed me how to put in a tampon. Only got it halfway. I associated my period with
an inexplicable phenomena.
My mother told me I had to use a rag. My mother said no to tampons.
You couldn't put that in your sugar dish?
Lord was in contact. Told my mother. She gave me Elizabeth Taylor paper dolls. 15 years old. My mother said, mazel tov. She slapped me in the face. Didn't know if it was a good thing or a bad thing.
My period? Like cake mix. Before it's cake.
Indian salad moss for 5 days. Wish I were Native American. I was 15 and I'd been hoping to get it. I was soft and I kept growing.
When I saw white girls in the gym with tampons, I thought they were bad girls.
Saw little red drops on the pink tiles. I said, yeah.
My mom was glad for me.
Used opiate like putting my fingers up there.
11 years old, wearing white pants. Blood started to come out.
Thought it was dreadful.
I'm not ready.
I got back pain.
I got party.
12 years old, I was happy. My friend had a leisure board. Asked if we were going to get our periods. Looked down and I saw blood.
Looked down and there it was.
I'm a woman.
Terrified. Never thought it would come.
Changed my whole feeling about myself. I became very silent and mature. A good Vietnamese woman. Quiet worker, virtuous, never speaks.
9 and a half. I was sure I was bleeding to death. Rolled up my underwear and threw them in the corner. Didn't want to worry parents.
My mother made me hot water and wine, and I fell asleep.
I was in my bedroom in my mother's apartment. I had a comic book collection. My mother said, you must have given your box of comic books.
My girlfriend told me, you hemorrhaged every month.
My mother was in and out of mental hospital. She couldn't take me going of age.
Dear Miss Carlin, please excuse my daughter from basketball. She has just matured.
They told me not to think about it now, period. They wiped me down with an antiseptic.
Scared people would smell it. Scared they'd say, I smell like fish.
Growing up, couldn't eat.
I got hungry.
Sometimes it's very red.
I like the drops of water from the toilet. Like pink.
Sometimes it's brown and it deserves me.
I was 12. My mother slapped me and brought me a red cotton shirt. My father went out for a bottle of Sangria.
Nairobi, Kenya was huge, and Birmingham, Alabama. There are also vagina holiday zones. New York City, Paris, Sarajevo, Manila, Santa Fe, Rome, Sydney. San Francisco has a status of its own. It's a vagina world fair zone. Well, Pittsburgh is also a vagina holiday zone. They are wild for vaginas in Pittsburgh. A woman from Pittsburgh was obsessed with this particular word, a pejorative word used to describe the vagina. permission to reconceive the word.
Snowflake?
Yes, snowflake.
bilang mga cookie. Wala nga naman akong masabi sa susunod na babae nito. Isa siyang sex worker sa Amerika. Ngunit, mga babae lamang ang kanyang pinagsisipihan.
Oye, kumalayo pa ito. Ang mga sari-sari sakit na kaakibat sa
Pero mas importante dyan, natuklasan ko kung paano ko nililibugan sa pananigin nila.
Nang matuklasan ko ang susi, pakiramdam ko na bigyan ko ng boses yung mga puhit. Maawin ko ang mga ito. Tuwing nalilipag-sex ako sa mga tahimik na babae, nahahanap ako ng isang lugar sa kanilang kaloob-looban at pati sila nabubunat sa mga halimin nila. Nalilipag-sex din ako sa mga mahilig malingin at pati sila nakakahalap na mas nanunood at mas malaming pang mga halimin. Yan, naging obsessed ako dyan. Gusto ko nang mahalingin lahat ng mga babae. Bantuhan sila kung natang isang pulbukon o kaya hindi na lang bala. Para pong isang operasyon. Isang delikadong siyensya, yung paghahanap ng tamang siyempo. Tamang kinalalagyan ng bawat halimin. Yan ang tawag ko dyan. Kung minsan, nahanap ko to sa taas ng maong ng isang babae. At gumagamang ako pataas mula rito. Tahimik na binabagla sa mga nakapanimod na alarma. Nahahandahan ko yung pinabasok. Kung minsan naman, gumagamit ako ng puwersa. Pero hindi yung bayonetyo nakaka-opress ng puwersa. Ako hindi yung nakakadumi na. Yung ba? Ito, magalala. Dadaling kita sa isang lugar. Relax ka lang dyan. Enjoy mo pang masyari. Yan. Yung ganyang klase puwersa. Kung minsan naman, nahahanap ko yung malingin bago pa magsimula ang lahat. Habang kumakain ng salad, kumakain ng manok. Napakakaswal na dyan lang sa dulo ng aking mga daliri. Kung minsan naman, gumagamit tayo ng flaps, diba? Hihilom sa flaps. Kung minsan, hinahayaan kong hanapin ang babae ang sarili niyang halinghing sa harap ko mismo. Nakihintay ako niya, nag-chacha na ako, hanggang sa may bukas niya ang kanyang sarili. Hindi ako pumapayag dyan sa mga peke at halatang halinghing na yan, hindi! Itutulak ko siya hanggang sa maabot niya ang sarili niyang makapangyarihang halinghing. Diyan yung halinghing ng tingin. Diyan yung halinghing ng puke, yung
thank you. I was there when her vagina opened. We were all there. Her mother, her husband, and I, and the nurse from the Ukraine with a whole hand up the vagina, eating and turning with her rubber glove as she talked casually to us, like she was turning on a loaded faucet.
Nang bumukadkad ang kanyang puwerta, naroon ako. Naroon kaming lahat, ang kanyang ina, ang kanyang kabiyak, at ako. At ang nurse mula sa Ukraine na nakikipag-usap sa amin ng buong kahinamunan habang sinasalat at dinuntukin ng kanyang nakagomang kwantis na kamay ang puwerta na para bang nagbubukas lang ng tribo ng tubig.
I was there in the room where the contractions made her fall on all fours, made unfamiliar moans leak out of her pores, and still there after hours when she just screamed suddenly wild, her arms striking at the electric air.
Naroon ako sa silid nang pagapangin siya sa sahig ng mga ilaw at nang humulas mula sa kanyang balat ang mga tagboy sa kung saan na hindi umuhupa, nilumilisan, walang takot nitong hinahangon ng panahon hanggang sa makapalahibo ang kanyang mga tili at sinuntok na niya ang aming ventilador ang nagahalat.
I was there when a vagina changed from a shy sexual hole to an archaeological tunnel, a sacred vessel, a Venetian canal, a deep well where a tiny child stuck there was waiting to be rescued.
Naroon ako nang magpalit ng anyo ang kanyang puwesta. Mula sa kiningari hanggang sa maging lapusang archaeological, sa Dragon Calis, Canal Venecia, balong kumakalong sa bumarang sanggol, naghihintay sa gibing.
I saw the colors of the vagina. They changed. Saw the bruised, broken blue, the blistering tomato red, the gray pink, the dark. Saw the blood-like perspiration along the edges. Saw the yellow, white liquid, the shit, the clots pushing out all the holes, pushing harder and harder. Saw through the holes the scratches of black hair. Saw it just there behind the bone. A hard, brown memory, as the nurse of the Ukraine kept turning and turning her slippery hand.
Saksi ako sa pagbabagong kulay ng ganyang nagsabahag-aring ari. Mula sa bulaghaw ng bubog at hubi-abong pasa, ang pula ng kamatis na pumutok sa halik ng araw, ang abuhing rosas at ang matingkad na rosas. Nakita ko ang amoy dugong pawis na umaagos sa gilid nito, ang likidong mamuti-muti, manilaw-milaw, dumi na mungtugo, pumulwak, lumusot sa lahat ng butas-butas, tulak sa lamang kumikit-kit, tiing masigasig. Tumatapos ang titik ko sa butas ng pinagulan. Inaaninap ko ang ulo ng sanggol at nasilip ko ang kinakalmot na buhok niyang kaitim. Mula sa sulok, mismo sa sukpungan ng butot laman, isang gunitang matigas at pilugan habang iniikot-ikot ng nars mula sa Ukraine ang madulas na kagomang buwantis niyang kamay.
I was there when each of us, her mother and I, held the leg and spread her wide, pushing with all our strength against her pushing, and her husband sternly counting, 1, 2, 3, telling her to focus, push harder. We looked into her then. We couldn't get our eyes out of that place.
Nakalilimutan natin ang puwerta. Lahat tayo. Paano natin may paliliwanag ang kakulangan sa pagpapakundangan at kawalang itagan? Ang kasalatan sa pagkamangha at paghahang. Naroon ako nang dinukit siya ng doktor. Gamit ang kagilagilaras na forcep, linamat ang kanyang bibig na huwag umaawit ng opera hanggang sa makaawit na ito ng maiting. Unang lumabas ang ulo, kasunod ang braso, pagbuhay ang katawan na maliksing lumamoy tungo sa mga braso, lumuluha sa patiyakap.
I was there later when I just turned and faced the vagina. I stood and let myself see her, all spread, completely exposed, mutilated, swollen, and torn, bleeding all over the doctor's hands. He was calmly sobbing her there.
Naroon ako nang binusaysay ko ang puwerta. nakipagkilala at tumitik sa buong pagmamalaki niyang pagkalikakan. Itinatangal ng burlis at sugat, ang pamamaga at pagkawara, habang marahan siyang tinatahiin ng tukto.
I stood and the vagina suddenly became a wide, red, pulsing heart.
Naroon ako habang minamalas ang dahang-dahang pagbulan, paglawak, pagsampunan ng puwertang naging pusong tumitibok.
The heart is capable of sacrifice, so is the vagina.
Kaya ng pusong mag-alay at magpakasakit, kaya rin ito ng puwerta.
The heart is able to forgive and repair. It can change its shape to let us in. It can expand to let us out. So can the vagina.
Kaya ng pusong magpatawad at mag-ilom, baguhi ng hugis, tumikom, magpasok, umalas at magpatansik. Kaya rin ito ng puwerta.
It can ache for us and stretch for us, die for us, and bleed us into this difficult, wondrous world.
Kaya ng puso magpasan, magbata, magdugo ng magdugo at mamatay para sa mundong kahihirap, kaysa klap at kailangan.
I was there in the room. I remember.
Naroon ako sa silid. Naalala ko.